Hello friends, welcome to knowledgewala.com. So today I'm going to continue on IBM Cúram build targets. So in my previous videos, I already explained about quotable changes and message file changes. So what kind of build we have to run when you are changing anything in quotable or in message file. So I will continue that series. So today I will discuss about modeling changes. So if you're changing your modeling, what kind of build targets you have to run in order to start reflecting your changes in your source code. So modeling changes can be three types of modeling changes you can do. You can change facade layer, you can change service layer, and you can change entity layer. So what kind of build targets we have to run when we are changing facade, when we are changing service layer, and when we are changing entity layer. So whenever we are changing modeling files, there are some files which extension is like emx and efx file. So these types of files are there which are generating and changing. So suppose you change anything in your facade class. Suppose you have one facade class that is called sample, and you added one method, or you can say you added one operation. So once you added one operation here, or maybe you are writing one new phrase facade class. So either you are writing a new facade class, or you are changing or adding in existing facade class. As it is related to modeling and it is a facade class, you have to run the generated list. So we have to run build generated. So why we are doing generated and what generated will do here? So basically generated will generate the artifacts from this modeling. So it will create Java files inside the INTF, inside base and file folders structure. So why we are not doing server here? Because server is a superset and it is having two branches, like generated and implemented. So here whenever we are writing or we are adding any new operation in the facade class, it needs handcrafted Java files. If you are doing server, as a part of server, it will do the build implementation, and once it is doing build implementation, then it will start looking a file which you created recently as a facade class. Or maybe if you added an operation in your existing facade class, it will check that operation and it won't get that operation or class file, and it will throw the exception and your build will fail. So in order to avoid that failure of your build target, you can break your steps. Like you can run build generated first. Once your build generated is passed and it is successfully completed, then you can refresh your Eclipse. Once your Eclipse is refreshed, then it will start displaying some issues in your problem section. And once you navigate that problem section, you will got to know it required one handcrafted implementation class. Or maybe if you added one new operation only, it will ask that operation is not available. Means there is one class, but it is not implemented all the methods. So what you have to do? So if it is a new class, you have to write one implementation class. And if it is a new operation you added, just add that operation in the existing handcrafted implementation class. So once you added or modified your existing facade implementation class, then you have to run one build that is called build implemented. So what this build command will do? Build implemented will check all the implementation, handcrafted implementation classes, Java files, and it will create a class of those Java files, and then it will create implementation.jar file, and the code will be used from implementation.jar file. Once your implementation implemented build command is passed successfully, then we have to do the build database. Why build database is required here? As we are not adding any entity. So as we are adding facade is supposed to insert in some tables in the database. Those tables name are functional identifier, identifier, and SID, FID, and security group SID, and security identifier. So these four tables are available in your database, where whenever you are adding a new operation in your facade class, we have to put the entry inside this. So when you are doing database build, the infrastructure automatically inserted data inside these tables. So if you are doing build database, automatically infrastructure will insert those records in these tables. So if you want to avoid that build database, then manually you can insert data inside these four tables. In this way, you can save your time. So once these four tables are updated or you executed your database and database build is passed, then you have to run the client. Because this facade class and facade operations are exposed to the client, so client build is also required in order to get those changes in the client side. So I can explain in a very brief manner. So whenever you are changing facade class or creating a new facade class, you have to do the build generated. Once your build generated is passed, refresh your Eclipse, implement your handcrafted implementation class, and then do the build implemented. Once build implemented is passed, then either you can do build database or manually you can insert record on security tables. Once this step is done, then we can run the client, because facades are exposed to the client. We have to do the client. Thanks a lot. In my next video, I will explain service layer changes. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day. Please send your comments. Thank you. Have a nice day.